This is Ducati's new Hypermotard Evo 1100. Now I really rate this bike. I've rode it around the streets of Bologna and I've rode it on track. And I think it makes a surprising alternative to a Sport 600. Now the GSX-R is a brilliant bike. I still race one today. And all that kind of range of bikes are excellent. But in the real world, on the road, you've got more torque, it's easier around town, it's fun to ride, you've got the Ducati Bologna name, the list is almost endless.
No. We're forgetting, Chad. There's a lot of downsides to this bike. I've got another alternative. Chad makes a very good point, but in the real world, the Triumph's got a more comfortable seat, it's got a better tank range, it's got more power, it's cheaper as well. I think this is a much better alternative in the real world than the Ducati.
But that's from Hinckley. This is Bologna. I don't have to dress as a Power Ranger to ride it. This is gorgeous.
Yeah, but this is British beef. It's a great looking bike. It's striking, it's meaty.
Yeah, you may have a better engine, but this just sounds better, looks better. It's more of a bike. There's only one way to sort this. Let's get our lids on and have a day's playing.
Let's do it.
Yeah, sports bikes are really good on B roads, but the Hypermotard had way more fun on these type of roads.
Yeah, fair point, but the speed truck's got wide bars. That's a lot of fun and just as easy to ride as the Hypermotard is.
Yeah, but the Hypermotard's great round town. I mean, the 600, you're going to be in agony. Same on the Speed Triple. It's way more fun on the Hypermotard. Look at the sports bike. It's all agony and dressed like a Power Ranger.
Yeah. The Speed Triple's just as good round town. And when we get on an A-Ride, I'll be leaving you for dead. You won't see which way I went.
Yeah, okay, the Triumph has got more grunt, but you still can't have fun like this. Backing it in sideways, the Hypermotard's got to be the one for giggle factor. Okay, so we're coming towards the end of the day, and we've ridden all three bikes. But for me, the Ducati, it just makes a surprising alternative. A lot of people are quick to slate it. And yes, it's a bit extreme, but around town, it's easier to ride than the GSX-R 600 and most sports bikes. And it's more fun, especially on B roads and back roads. You don't have to double the national speed limit to have fun. And compared to the big Triumph, well, that's heavy and it's got a great engine, but it's nowhere near the looks of the Ducati.
I see what you're saying, but the Hypermotard is great fun for the first 20 minutes, but after that it just gets a bit tiring, it's too extreme. It's got a better riding position than the GSX-R for road riding, I'll agree, but so does the Speed Triple. And the rest of the time it's a more practical bike and it's got a better motor. For me, the Hypermotard is just too extreme, it's a bit of a toy. That's why you aren't great, but for normal people, Speed Triple over time, or any super naked in fact.
So if you dare to be a bit different, give the Ducati a test ride, you won't be disappointed. But if you want run-of-the-mill, go with like run-of-the-mill sports bikes, run-of-the-mill nakeds, but try the Ducati, it's a little bit different and a little bit fun.